Legendary plus plus Iron Man. We are playing on a modded higher, way higher than legendary difficulty. Lots and lots and lots of additional enemies. And the whole campaign is hanging at a thread, so to speak. Look at that. This is our roster. A couple of our primary guys are being injured. If we take a look at the memorial, we'll see so far we lost three soldiers, two of them being rangers, and unfortunately also Sergeant Commander G, who gave his life in one of the missions. It was one of our snipers. So two rangers, one sniper died so far. And now let's take a look why this whole campaign is hanging at the thread. We have, as you can see, only two more days left. We definitely need to go for this Blacksite mission because the doom counter is already ticking. And with only 2 days left, the 3 days potential recovery time for our most reliable soldiers are a little bit too much. So yeah, very much to our displeasing, we can't take more than these guys on the mission. We pre-selected also the loadouts. Don't have anything here for this loadout, unfortunately. Only one, the maximum of one grenade per soldier. Buying items is not really an option either. We only have 18 and we're running short of time, so yeah, not really going to happen. Not really going to happen. So that is it, the last stand. We are going for the first Blacksite mission. I wouldn't necessarily say this is our A team, but it is as close as it gets to the best team that we can currently field. So yeah, let's go.
In position for deployment.
Our contacts in the local resistance have shown us how to access the Advent Blacksite. The aliens worked hard to keep this.
The names of the missions are becoming increasingly hilarious. Welcome to Operation Half-Eaten Wolf. After naming the whole family Diamond Mother, Stone Father, Swamp Child, Mountain Father, I think it was. Now we are finally at Half-Eaten Wolf. I think Bradford is having some sort of psychological issue to always rename the missions after these, like, very, very strange occasions. But yeah, Blacksite mission called named Half-Eaten Wolf is promising us some ridiculously interesting run. Let's see if the mission will live up to its name. We need to succeed on this mission, otherwise the whole campaign is over. I guess it can't be more difficult or more intense than that. I'm back to my old gaming equipment again. So yeah, we do have the standard setup, so to speak. It is a non-timed mission. I'm expecting approximately 25 to 30 alien enemies. And the reason why I'm so relentlessly scrolling in the dark is I think the high ground, which is available here, will also impose a risk because there will probably be a tower up here anyways. So first things first, we want to take the high ground, of course. I think there's going to be some sort of a train station in the middle here in this dark alleyway. And yeah, like I was saying, we will definitely have a lot of enemies on this mission. That's a given. Usually, even on normal legendary, it's up to, if not exceeding, 20. So I wouldn't be super surprised to see anything in the ballpark figure of 30 aliens on this mission. Obviously, with the higher difficulty and all of the additional aliens, I have no idea how many aliens will be on this mission. But with the increased pack size, yeah, probably will end up above 30. Which is hilarious if you think about it.
Affirmative, moving out.
Okay, so good news number one, we do not have a tower up here, at least not on this side. Let's just move up and see if there's a tower on the other side. Tactic here is pretty much straight. Yeah, there's the tower that I was talking about. We're still concealed though, which doesn't necessarily mean the tower is to be taken lightly. The opposite is true. The tower has a lot of hit points. We could use a grenade to just explode it and instantly kill it. But if our team has one, if our team is lacking one specific element, then I would say it's the number of grenades available to our squad. Now, since towers themselves are stationary, one of the other tactics that you can do is you can heavily rely on your squad side to take care about them. And this is probably also what we're going to do. We do have two rangers who, in theory, can remain cloaked once we start engaging on the tower. And our two snipers could stay out of range, so if Duchess is being able here to spot out the tower, yeah, that's fine. Then my question would be, how far away do I need to be in order to no longer see the tower directly, but yet being able to... Yeah, that's good. And that is squad side distance. Perfect. I think we could do the same here for Dope Disor. If he... Yeah, he's in squad side range as well. As long as there are... not really close to it, it's fine. Although he is pretty much on the edge. So let me try something else real quick. Like Dopar, how about you just go here? The whole point here is to not waste any grenades that early. We will definitely need them a little bit later on. So yeah, we want to stay out of range with whoever has not the Phantom ability, and we'll just kill the tower with our snipers. So let's see. This here is only squad side. So I think we're going to be out of range. This here is also only squad side. Yeah. Once we trigger it, there's no turning back. He is out of range. I would want to put him here though, just to be out of vision range as well. Duchess and Nightcom both have phantoms, so they won't be spotted out. And now our tactic, instead of like grenading it, in order to preserve some more grenades, is we are going to use squad side and just kill it via squad side. I'm very displeased to see that this tower has 4 armor. I am not sure where we are already seeing the advanced towers. That's a very bad sign. Advanced towers usually start with power level 14 plus. So if the aliens really decide to go ham on us, like they are obviously currently trying, they are deploying towers. Towers are in the same Power range is berserkers, archons, so we could see any of these guys here. Really depressing. And the reason why I don't like it is, imagine we deal minimum damage, that's just 2 points of damage on this tower. Armor penetrating rounds would be golden. Alright, so as I was initially suggesting, they will probably be spotted out, so that's really no surprise. I'm just giving a protocol here to Dopa Desor because I still don't know whether or not he's in vision range. Just want to make sure that no one here is being attacked by the tower. Tower is stationary, so it obviously can't move. We can abuse that to our advantage. Clever usage of game mechanics here to just use squad sight as much as possible. Yeah, and four armor is unfortunately really, really bad. I hope we are not triggering too many towers. Like, theoretically, the mods shouldn't modify the towers too much, but there can be up to 3 or even 4 towers on the whole mission. So yeah, a lot of minimum damage here. At least the shots are hitting, so let's not complain about it. There we go. That's the first tower down. And we finally secured the rooftop and could now move on to the train yard, which is probably the quote-unquote crux of the whole map here. Let's see how this one works out for us.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Okay, so observation number one, they're not seeing anyone. That's not necessarily a bad sign. If you don't see anyone, it at least means that you can move up without triggering, which is good. Right, so maybe we just go a little bit further here with Duchess. Yeah, there's the first pack, but she's still concealed, so no reason to take a sweat. Let's hope that the pack itself is not moving. We're reloading with a sniper who has just blue moved. Angstrom himself is also... Yeah, the only one who could trigger is Dopa Desor. Yeah, and he just triggered. That's the disadvantage of moving them up, but we really needed to move up the sniper, so there was not much of an option here. Guardian ability just kicking in for our specialist. He was hitting the first shot, hence he got a second shot for free. And yeah, the second pack, luckily for us, didn't trigger. That's really good. That's really good. So we're now a little bit in an exposed position. We could go for a hack, but the problem is that the gremlin might trigger when we're going down here. I'm not sure if there's a second pick back here, and I don't want to trigger just a second pick. And plus, we are pretty much flanking like both of them, so these should be very, very decent shots hitting the two guys. Specifically, I'd like to hit the shield bearer to prevent him from creating any additional shields for these guys. Two shots with 100% should be enough to take down the shield bearer. So off we go. Yeah, the first one alone was critical. Second one seals the deal. So we're not going to move much. Nightcom is still in cover, which is good. We are going to move her into Nightcom's position after we cleared this guy down here. Dopa Desor has lightning hands. He shouldn't trigger the other pack. I'm also not willing to move because there's not like so much cover that we could use. So that could be 3 points of damage, and I'm counting on it. Yep, instead of counting on it, he just decided to completely miss. That's also one option. So if Dopa Desor kills this one, we still have enough to kill the mech, I think, at least. So Dopa, go for it. Yeah. Promotion earned, that's what we wanted to hear. Now Nightcom is just going to go down here, A, to free up the room, B, to also spot a little bit more and see if we have other packs down there. And with regards to the Advent mech, we're just taking a solid shot here to shredder it, and afterwards we're finishing it with a sniper. No, none of these should be targeted. Go for the mech, please, 100%. And yeah, that's the first pack down. Three more guys down. Duchess, I think I'm still going to keep her up here. There's really no need to get aggressive now. And I also think that these guys will probably trigger next round. I wouldn't be surprised, though. Okay, they aren't, which is good. That'll give us a little bit more time to reload and get our setup straight. Wangstra needs to reload. Our heavy needs to reload. Dopa Desor definitely needs to reload. He has a free, I think he has a free reload though. Yeah, auto reloader. So we're not going to reload him as of now. We're going to reload him next turn because he still has, he just has the normal auto loader. So let's start scouting ahead here. We are very, very close to trigger these guys, and once they are changing their position, they'll automatically trigger. But for whatever reason, they decide to stay, which is interesting. Okay, it's not that we're in a hurry, I'm just repositioning. And yeah, that here could be a trigger. Great. This is going to be an Overwatch trap. Muton Centurion plus 3 sectoids. Wow. That's a lot of HP, and we need to be careful that these guys are not joining as well. Yeah, well, look at that. Muton Centurion. By moving here, we would already start to trigger that other pack. Although, I must say, I'm pretty surprised that they are out of vision range. Pretty surprised, to be honest. Let's just move here to see if that is really the case. Seems as if they are gone. The reason why I would want to move up, to be honest, is we need to shred the Muton Centurion. He has 3 armor, and we want to get rid of the armor before we can kill it. So let's take the move here to half cover. Did pretty much work out. I like it. Let's hope we're hitting the shot. Okay, so that's the necessary shredding that we needed. Nobody's org now can finally reload. Free reload for him, that's not a problem. And he'll probably have the best shot to kill the Centurion. Good job, well done, bro, well done. There's still a sectoid on the loose. So yeah, here we go. All right, the way we want to deal with this is we're giving our first unit that is in vision, which is our Grenadier. We're giving her the 8 protocol, which is going to give her threat assessment. So she, no matter what the sector does, she will get one free Overwatch shot. And the other free Overwatch, the other Overwatch will take ourselves. So Wangstra is being on Overwatch in case they are approaching a little bit closer. Now, Duchess here, we can retain her in cover for now, because I'm not terribly afraid about the sectoids. Once the other pack is approaching us, we'll however also attack with her. Now that was the threat assessment that I was talking about earlier. And now we are in a solid mind control situation. Good lord. Mind control is not funny. Okay, so Duchess here can remove the cover and also will drop her concealment, which is not too bad. Let's remove the cover to make sure that our next shot will be a solid hit. Dopa Desor could directly take a shot. Our other sniper needs to reload first and foremost. So yeah, it's going to be 6 points of damage in minimum, so I'm not going to take the sidearm lightning hands. Instead, let's just take a solid shot here. And that's it. No more mind control, right? Right. Wangstra is just moving up a little bit more. It's going to be an Overwatch as well. Reload. There's still one more sectoid. I'm pretty interested where that guy is. Nightcom is still going to be our scout for now. Good evening, by the way, chat. You are pretty quiet today. Feel free to interact a little bit so I can answer some questions. Towers themselves, unfortunately, do not provide any cover. That's the reason why I'm not moving there. I think it's a good time for us to move up, just to get a little bit more, let's say, our squad together on one position. What's over there? We want to keep as many Overwatch shots as we can. So yeah, let's move only one sniper. Again, we're not in a hurry here. This is really working out well so far. Overwatch. Scanning. Come get some. Affirmative. Cover me now. One last sector is on the loose. He was around here in the back. I know that. And there was just a second pick. Okay. This here unfortunately is no cover, like the only potential cover is here. And The tower itself is deceiving. The tower is no cover whatsoever, so pretty bad to just stay there. Now the next pack is probably going to arrive. I wouldn't be surprised if we will find another Overwatch trap. We'll now take our scout and we'll just use our squad site to the maximum advantage. We have high ground, pretty decent aiming odds.
Understood. Moving out. Affirmative. Covering now. I'm on it.
Scanning. Taking single moves with our point guard here. Once the guys are moving into this direction, that's going to be a dead zone. Like, both of the snipers will have pretty good odds on hitting something. Meanwhile, we can already move one of the guys down here. The ones with the lower range that need to be closer. In this, on this medium to high distance, they are no longer profiting that much from the high ground. The weapon accuracy will drop significantly. That's the reason why I just move up both of the snipers effectively, bringing them into a solid position. Wangstra himself will join the guys down there. Okay, and after everyone moved, not before, take Overwatch shots. I also didn't move the point guard because I didn't want to trigger something this round. Pretty sure we will hit something very soon.
That's affirmative.
All right, that's the building itself. Yeah, and lots of hostiles. In front of the building alone, there are usually three patrols. I know, or we know that one of the patrols is the one with the Vipers. We now have seen that's a patrol with a Centurion. Yeah, there he is. Centurion, Stun Lancer, Elite Trooper, and another Elite Trooper. We can't move Nightcom anymore, and these guys have solid cover, so we need to engage here. And that's the perfect position for our first grenade. And I like the fact that we have upgraded our grenade launchers. Look at that huge grenade spread. We will reach everyone and get rid of the cover. That's really, really worthwhile. So, selling all that shit on the black market is definitely worth it. Okay, we do have two snipers. I guess the question of the day is half cover or no cover, or standing back. And I think the answer is pretty clear here. We want to eliminate these guys, so the matter of the fact is the most dangerous foe is this Muton Centurion. That's the reason why we target him first, then the Stun Lancer, and then the other two gentlemen. So yeah, one shot. And a miss. That's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. Duchess here has the beacon in case things do not go as planned. And currently they aren't, to be honest. We would have wanted to kill this guy first. Wow, another miss. That's really bad. No, This is becoming increasingly more problematic than I would have expected. Lots of 80 and 90% shots being wasted here. We killed the Centurion, which is good. And we now need to use the beacon, I'm pretty sure. Like 99% sure of the it's going to be beacon time. All right, second unpleasant fact is if they run towards the beacon, I didn't want to throw it too far here, just not to prevent triggering another pack. Second unpleasant fact is Nightcom here will be revealed because they will just pass him. And the question is, shouldn't we just instead reveal ourselves and kill this guy? We're not triggering anything because there's nothing in range. We might trigger something next round, but that's okay. So that would be the end of our scouting. But given that we have missed so many shots, yeah, let's just try it. So both of them will go for the beacon. Wow, he really missed the beacon. That's rare. Very rare. And the stun lance is going to stun lance. Yeah, that's what I expected. Wow, minimum damage with the stun lance. That's really bad. Like, what the fuck is wrong with the AI in our days? Good, so dupe it is over. Reload. You could just lightning hands. We could kill him with the sniper. That's an option. But the question is, isn't it better to reload with the snipers?
Let's do this.
And just instead use our 100% shots here. Langstra has so many kills already, by the way, so might as well give the rookies a little bit more kills. Specifically her. Because we need high level rangers as well. Good, so this guy's down. I'm taking this shot here. Because I don't feel really well with Nightcom being that exposed up front. Not going to run here, that could trigger another pick. This is something that we're going to do next round. We don't need to be greedy now, we have enough time. Wow, two autoloaders, not too bad. Our snipers will be happy. Autoloaders for everyone.
Is it clear? Heading to that location.
Full cover, half cover, full cover. And I think we're still going to stay with our snipers up here. The oversight is just too good for now, even though it's a negative aiming penalty, which is already probably surpassing the positive high ground penalty. Still, having the snipers, or having the ability to shoot wherever you like with the snipers is really, really good, so might as well use that one. Alright, so these guys are. Everyone here is in full cover.
If you say so.
Oh, that was a misclick. The mouse somehow jumped. Anyways, let's just go back into cover. Maybe I'll let one of the snipers up here, and the other one is just proceeding to help the guys out.
Already there.
Probably should have done it the other way around, but his aura has lightning hands, and that is only useful in close range. So let's take this as an opportunity to also reposition Dopa. We're just going to move up for now. Reloading whoever needs reloading. Yeah, I should have moved Dopa Desor to the front because he has the lightning hands, and that's just a smarter move. Good, so let's just put the guys in a proper position here, that all of these moves shouldn't really trigger something. And one more move that I would want to do, let's get our sniper here onto the train wreck, because all of this here, the high ground, is effectively going to block her vision. So yeah, let's move her here. We still have the battle scanner, might as well use it to make sure we know what's up here. There's another tower up here, which we can kill with a clever grenade.
On Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
Scanning.
On Overwatch. Affirmative. Covering now.
I don't think we're alone out here.
No, I don't think you're alone. Well, that's a fair assessment. So this door here is open, is it? Yeah, that door here is open, so aliens are already patrolling. And look at that. For whatever reason, we can see that there is a mech pack within here. We also know there is still one more Viper pack. I don't know where the fuck they are currently. Probably anywhere in this direction. Not sure. Might also be the case that they are moving alongside this part of the building. Let's give ourselves two or three more rounds of Overwatch here. I still have the feeling that a pack will wander into us. And if nothing happens, we are going to take care about that tower next. Overwatch.
Hey, you hear anything?
Nope, nothing happened. All right. Nightcom still has a grenade. Wangstra still has a grenade. We have one more grenade in our grenade thrower. Yeah, and even our sniper still has her grenade. So we will need to throw it up there, effectively, which means we are going to go to here and are just moving alongside the building to make sure that we are not triggering something. And once we're at the other door, we'll start to engage on the tower. Good, let's aggressively use our sniper, because she's probably going to throw the grenade. It's very uncommon that a sniper is in range to throw grenades, so let's use the standing target tower as a good practicing target for her. She's the most unlikely to throw a grenade in a normal fight. Alright, Nightcom's taking the lead here, as so often.
I hope it's worth it.
we are now going to approach like the site. The only thing which would be negative now is if the Viper pack would be behind us for whatever reason. We do have a pretty well positioned Dopa Desor here, and if the Viper pack would walk around that street, yeah, that would be unpleasant. So yeah, we are now figuring out that the aliens were abusing abdominis to experiment on them. Much to our surprise, who would have thought? They are not the friendly guys from the neighborhood. Right, so let's move our sniper up. Okay. Dupa de Zor is going to move here. Just don't want to have the really, he triggered it? How? Everyone else hasn't triggered it, but Doper did for whatever reason. Okay, is she having any sort of throwing angle here? Yeah, she has.
Get ready for a surprise.
Indeed, get ready for a surprise. She just killed the tower. Towers are automatically being killed once they are being hit by a grenade because the building collapses, and since they can't move, they instantly die. So that's a very cheesy but yet extremely efficient way of getting rid of them. And somehow I couldn't be arsed to fight regularly against it. Also, Haywire Protocol wouldn't have really benefited us, and I wanted to save the Haywire Protocol for the mech which is inside. Because maybe we get a good hack on the mech, and that is much more valuable than the tower itself. Also, of course, we wanted to save the grenade of our grenadier, and that was the reason why we haven't used it. Yeah, everything works according to plan. I'm only concerned about that one little pack with the Viper. It's somewhere here, and I don't know where. Good, so we know in minimum there is one loose sector from here, running around somewhere. We know there is a pack with a Viper and two sectoids also running around somewhere. And we know there is a pack with a mech, and I suppose probably Advent soldiers helping it, also running around. So a minimum three more or less packs. Yeah. Interesting, the door here is open, which means someone has passed by recently. The door is open. Maybe they went around here? That's really, 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 really strange. We haven't triggered anything yet. That's the reason why I'm carefully advancing. There's no need to go in as of now. Let's just get everyone in position. We have three potential Overwatch shots. Wangstra here has also line of sight in case something's in here. So even four Overwatch shots. Yeah, and that's the beauty of an Overwatch trap. Alright, 7 points of damage on a biological unit. Yeah, that's one trooper down. Mech and two more troopers to go.
I'll get him next time.
Negative damage.
Normal troopers, to be honest. That's interesting. I haven't seen those in a while. I don't know how high our chance to haywire protocol is. Last time it was 30%, and that was not really convincing. Yeah, it's still 35%. Wangstra, you're an awesome combateer, but your hacking skills still suck dick. Hey, greetings, Commander. Welcome back. It is going great. Kresko, yes, that's the first black side. We try to let the Doom counter descend as much as possible. Successfully, if I may add. And we're now very, very close to final destruction, quote unquote. So now this black side is no longer optional. We need to successfully finish it. So, two shots. 94%. Yeah, first one pretty solid hit.
Deflection.
Another 90% shot here. And that was the mech. I don't want to trigger another pick, so that's the reason why I'm now moving a little bit more careful here. Good, solid 60% shot. Yeah, not as solid as it appeared on paper. We can't kill him with the lightning hands, so might as well take the normal shot, 60%.
Hostile neutralized.
Another 60% shot. Wow, my guys are not on fire today, that's for sure. But there is the hair trigger. If you miss twice, bro, you just proved that you've just proven that you're incompetent. Okay. I'm not terribly afraid about a normal advent trooper. That's the reason why I haven't used any mimic beacon and so on and so forth. There is the peg that I was looking for. And by the way, it also explains where the last sector is. The last sector just teamed up with these guys. Yeah. Well, now let's reconsider our situation. There's one little sector up here. Okay. There is a Viper in full cover, sector here, and a sector here in full cover. Now, these guys are a little bit more dangerous. Let us start by getting these guys here out of full cover, shall we? Like this here, shouldn't be a problem. Viper is our first target, and then we'll take care about the sectoids, one after the other. Good, so the sector is without any cover. The Viper has mediocre cover. Now it's a good time for your lightning hands, by the way, buddy. Solid dodge, 50-50 on a normal shot, 80% on a sniper shot. If we just, wow, we got him down to 1 HP. Terrifying. I'm thinking about how we can kill that Viper next, because it start getting on my nerves. A sectoid here is not worth a full shot. We could move Wangstra to go to here, and then just take care about the Viper, which is probably not a bad decision, to be honest. Here is even better because that's full cover. So yeah, let's start with this and to make sure that this pesky Viper is dying. Yeah. Good. Next up, let's kill the sectoid here. So instead of taking any very special shots, let's just use our pistol. 90% shot. Done. This here is a nice flanking position. Into full cover with our shotgun. 100%. Good chance of critting it. Yeah, and instant killed. It has to be dead. Hair trigger for free action effectively right. Means we can reload. Good, and last but not least, we do have one more soldier who could take a shot on that guy in full cover, or yeah, probably the guy on full cover. I don't want to take any more risks by pulling something else, so question is, if I just move back here, you don't want to pull any other pack. That's the main goal for now. Since I don't have any confirmation that outside there will be a line of sight, I'm just taking half cover here. It's not the most beautiful cover. And the 50-50 against the sector will probably not kill it. So instead, let's just overwatch. Question from the chat, am I uploading this to my YouTube channel? Yes, I will. I will put it into very little pieces, so one mission at a time, and upload it to the YouTube channel. Probably it's going to be uploaded on Monday, so tomorrow. Okay, so he decided to reanimate. Nothing wrong with that in general. Only that I don't like reanimations, so yeah, let's try to kill this guy with Wangstra. Yep,
there you go,
and the zombie also died. So that has taken care about all of the known aliens on the map. Which doesn't mean that there is not another last pack in here.
Moving out.
I'm a little bit surprised about how easy that was so far. I was expecting a little bit more resistance. Great, Commander. That's nice to hear. I always like YouTube subscribers. You will get all of the videos and the content basically a little bit later there. Yeah, and that's the pack that I was talking about. I could be a prophet in this game. I'm foreseeing things that are about to happen a little bit later. So, Muton Centurion, two Vipers, three Vipers. Wow, that's a difficult pick. And I was asking, I was literally asking for more when the game told me, yeah, please, here is what you've asked for. I think we're going to beacon that one. Not sure, but the likelihood is very, very high that this is going to happen. The real annoying part is that this cover, at least as far as I'm concerned, is non-destructible cover. So we cannot get rid of the frame here. They will definitely retain their cover. There are advantages though, because they cannot advance either. So if we take full cover, that basically means we will retain our full cover. We can, however, remove the cover of that snake here. And although we haven't dealt any damage to it, I would still argue that it was worth removing it, because now we can just take rapid fire shots onto it. Yeah, one shot was dodged, but the second one was a critical, so yeah, one Viper down. Next up. The everlasting question, whom should we target? The Centurion in half cover is a really bad shot, as you can see. So we are going for the Vipers. 50-50 here is okay. And shooting or hitting them for 6 damage kind of tells me that I was right. It is an okay shot. We are going to switch places here, so Dopadizor should have a little bit better aiming angle. Yeah, from here he can see everyone.
Moving to designated position.
We're taking full cover, as you guys can see. Basically making sure that we're going to survive that round. And we're going out of line of sight of these guys here. Okay, these two were the spiders, the vipers rather, and one was literally falling through the roof. I don't know what exactly happened, but I've seen hit points here at the gas tank, so I suppose they are standing next to the gas tank, which by the way would be a really shitty idea. So if you are an alien, let me tell you that standing next to a gas tank is a pretty shitty idea. I don't know what exactly you're expecting to happen, but in the majority of cases, what's going to happen is that people are going to blow you up. One could, of course, argue they are not knowing our physics well enough, so they effectively don't know that this is a gas tank. But yeah, let's give it a try. I've seen a lot of hit point damage, so 3 points for the Viper, and the Centurion himself also received a couple of points of damage. Just using the snipers now. We could get aggressive. Basically run here. Let's take a look. We could always run back in case it's too dangerous. It's a 50-50 on him. I'm not really such a big fan of these odds. We still have we could use threat assessment here on Wangstra, which basically means if something is moving here, we would automatically take a shot. We could use threat assessment on him, which is probably even better. Not sure. Wangstra has very sick aim, so if we can, we could also just overwatch. No, let's threat assess on him, her. Is she still having ammunition, by the way? Yeah, enough ammunition, so she has enough ammunition to take the shot. The reason why I'm now threat assessing on her is that she's closer to the front line. A, it will give her additional defense in case someone is taking a shot at her. B, she will be able to take a shot herself. Now, Dopa is going to go on to Overwatch, and we're just getting out of line of sight. Now, they should approach, and we should take a couple of shots. Wow, the Centurion unfortunately just dodged. Is this really happening? Are we missing all of our Overwatch shots? Wow, and one more dodge. Hey, Sealton, greetings. Welcome to the stream. Good evening, everyone, and good evening, Nightcon. Sealton, I am using the True Concealment mod. Yes, that is the case. Because the reason why I have play tested when the chat and myself decided to go like for a legendary plus Ironman, we play tested, and in the play test we found out that the biggest problem was not finding tactically sound decisions, but timers were increasingly short because the fights usually took, each pack took one more round to clear. So effectively on a normal map you had three turns less, and that was the reason why we opted for the True Concealment mod, because it solved our issue. So yeah. Which was fine. We needed a little bit playtesting to be honest. So at the beginning, we also tried the aiming improve for the aliens. Oh, what's going on with the game? It's currently moving on its own. We tried the aiming increase with the aliens, which turned out to be not optimal, because the aiming increase and the increased numbers together were just like too much. The game now seems to be a little bit buggy. For some reason, I was just tapping out to Twitch in order to answer you. But the game itself seems frozen now. Yeah. I probably need to restart the game. Okay, I don't need to restart it. The task manager helped me. Good. So let's continue. We are, for those who just joined, we are in the middle of a Blacksite mission, the first Blacksite mission. And it couldn't be more down to the wire. If we lose this Blacksite mission, we are basically F star 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 CK ED. Because we are, our doom counter is at 2 days. Hence, we will make sure that we are not losing it. Might sound simple, but it indeed is simple. Okay, so we still have the Centurion and we still have the Viper. The Viper is in grenade range. The Centurion will take 2 proper hits in order to die. If we move to here, that would be pretty exposed, and we need to make sure that there's no more pick. I'm pretty sure that this is the last pick, and if we move and trigger something here, we can still move back, so there is nothing lost by going here. Good. That is definitely, that will definitely not be the case once we move here with run and gun. Probably going to move here with run and gun, but yeah. Let's first and foremost take care about the Viper. We need to reload anyway, so we are just going to take a couple of shots into cover now. The Viper should be 50-50 shots. If everything else fails, we are going to take a grenade. Yeah, but that was okay. So that worked out pretty well. Now, next up, let's run and gun. Get to here. Shouldn't trigger anything because there is no more peck. How wrong you are, Saiken. How wrong you are. Again, you triggered something. Needless. Totally needless. Okay, we can't move him away. We need to come up with an idea. That was not the smartest play ever. I don't have the ability to inspire movement turns so far, so it's simply going to be a solid kill. It's simply going to be a solid kill. Let's try to kill both of the troopers. Solid miss. A little bit damaged, but I was honestly expecting like 2 hits. Bro, why exactly can you only see the sector? Like, that's the worst sniper ever. I would have expected you to see a little bit more. Good, and now the question is, what are we going to do with you, big guy? Both of our rangers are exposed anyways, so there is absolutely no advantage of moving her away. It's just disadvantageous, because if she's just moving away, effectively she will leave one, will leave the other ranger alone, and the mutant Centurion will be alive. So no, that's not going to happen. We committed to it, and now we need to take the consequences, more or less. Let's move up and try to go for a flashbang. Yeah, flashbang is not having enough range. That is bitter, very bitter.
I'm on the move.
So, question from the chat. Besides a couple of statements, we had Commander Ironman, hard enough for me. Yeah, bro, you're going to improve over time. It's about right decision making, not fucking it up like I just did. It's about doing having the right decisions in most of the situations. Officers have the standard aim on legendary is 70 for officers on the first force tick, and marking gives a plus 20. So 70 plus 20 minus 40 is effectively 50-50. So 64% chance mostly. That's when you start to fight with them at the beginning. We're going to take Overwatch. Maybe they are moving. Okay, that's good. You would be surprised, but that was really okay-ish. And now... I was hoping... Oh, they are instead... that's interesting. Why are they overwatching instead of killing? That's very interesting. We need to remove his overwatch, and then we can flashbang in order to break the mind control, which is going to be our target for now. So let's inspire everyone here with plus 20 crit chance. Inspiring range, by the way, before we do it. Inspiring range, by the way, is here. So all of these guys will be super inspired and they will say, yeah, bro, we are now more, we can finally crit more. Thank you so much, Wangstra, you are the man. Good, so Overwatch is removed. Wangstra's 100 aim is paying dividends. I'm very surprised that I got away with this. This is rather uncommon. Good. So, a couple of bits and pieces of site information here. As you might be aware, flashbang grenades are indeed not only removing Overwatch, but they are also breaking any Psy effect. So Overwatch removed, as you have seen, and surprise, also the mind control just broke. So yeah, if you're ever mind controlled, like I was recently, try using a flashbang, bro. You will see the results are great. Good. 50-50 to kill this trooper. Yeah, the guys are on fire now. I can see that. They are really pissed about what just happened. Let's take a blue move and see if we're triggering something. I think no. But yeah, don't count on my word. Like, when I'm saying I'm not triggering something, there is a certain tendency that the opposite is true. Yeah, you can break mind control exactly that way, so even one more reason to bring the good old flashbangs to all of your missions. 87% to hit him, or 96% to sword kill him. Crocodile Dundee style with a machete in his face. Don't forget, machetes, any type of melee weapons, are dealing 2 extra points of damage against sectoids. So even though we haven't upgraded them, they are still efficient. Question from the chat, will I be able to bring more grenades later with my upgrades? Yes, but only on grenadiers. So, we were just chit-chatting a little bit, but you guys might not have seen, in the meantime, while we were chit-chatting, we just killed a Centurion, 3 fucking Vipers, Sectoid, and 2 Advent Soldiers. That's an overall 7 dead aliens. Plus, yeah, these douchebags here, like the mech and 3 of his Advent Soldiers, like 3 more Sectoids, and that Viper here. So pretty much, I think 13 overall in the main chamber. Yeah, that's intense. Different grenades or just multiple of the same? You will usually have a grenade slot with your grenadier. And the grenade slot is the one which is multiplied by 2. So whatever you put in there will be multiplied. I am tending to bring a good mixture of grenades because I like many different grenades. They do have their situational value, most of them do. So I tend to use a mixture in the end. But if you were to ask me, like, what's your normal loadout, the most grenades that we will bring are going to be plain and simple plasma grenades, because we want to remove cover. It's as simple as that. I'm often using the grenades to remove cover. Good. So the extraction zone is up here. There will be reinforcements anywhere around the extraction zone. That's not a secret.
Okay, I'll go.
So before we start the event, I would want to kind of bring the snipers into a position where they do have high ground, do no longer need to move, and will be able to take shots. Then we will start the event. Wangstra can go here. We're just positioning ourselves for the last stint. And guys, you need to remind me, I need to update Nightbot because it's still giving you the same messages. Tomorrow I will update it. It's a little bit outdated, but yeah, you can still check the YouTube channel there. Good. So, let's just get the snipers up here. I don't care so much about cover because we will face reinforcements mainly, hence cover is specifically in the surprise round obsolete. We want to take reaction shots mainly. Well, but by thinking about it, let's at least consider where could, yeah, they are probably here somewhere. Let's still take a little bit of cover.
Heading there now.
I don't want to stand corrected by some weird triggering when they are instantly triggering and one of my guy takes a lethal shot because I haven't taken cover. Then the last laugh will be on them and not on me. So let's just take some cover. You don't have the vial yet. No, I don't. I am going to obtain it now. Here we are. Blacksite vial.
Guessing that's not water in there. Shen, any readings?
No signs of radioactivity. No significant energy signatures of any kind. Whatever it is, it's safe to handle.
We've confirmed acquisition of the sample. Move to rendezvous at the extraction point.
Looks like they called in backup.
Okay, so much for the location where they might spawn. It's right in fucking front of us.
Rolling.
Remember, it's going to be a drop of 4, so might as well be any form of mech or advent soldier. Really, anything goes. Just putting the guys here to have a proper overwatch. That's a pretty retarded position that he's in. Maybe this side here is safer. But honestly speaking, the stone needs to be a little bit bigger. Like, dude, we don't have enough cover for the two of us. But Nightcom has 14 hit points. Nothing can crit for 14 at the moment, so might as well leave him there. I think it's going to be one mech and 3 soldiers. And I was right again.
Got some advent here.
Okay, that looks like a well architectured action film. And they just fucked them up real hard. Look at that. Mech is down. Whatever that poor guy was is down. Yeah. GG.
I guess that'll be okay.
They literally just landed and found out the hard way that it was a bad idea. Yep. It was a bad idea. Yep, it was a bad idea.
Enemy eliminated. I'm on the move. Got it covered.
Affirmative, covering now.
So there's just one more pack of reinforcements incoming. Was to be expected. Well, the snipers should just stay there. That's cool.
If you say so.
Everyone just moves up a little bit.
Okay,
ICOM can move up. Lovely. Wangstruck can move up here, also good.
Heading there now.
All right, so everyone is indeed
Overwatch.
I'm on it.
On Overwatch now.
On Overwatch. Scanning. I'm on it.
One mech, one stormtrooper, one captain, one advanced normal soldier. One mech, one stormtrooper, one advanced soldier. Instead of the captain, they brought a shield lancer. I was wrong, but it was nearly the exact composition that I was foreseeing. Good. This time they survived a little bit longer.
I'm trusting you here.
Yep. Nightcom is going to move up. Shotgun in the face. Advent Stun Lancer. GG.
That's it.
He just earned his promotion. Well done, Nightcom. Well done, bro.
Well,
snipers are hopefully going to kill this guy here. Yep. Done deal. Oh, that's full cover, I see. We don't have suppression so far. But we do have a grenade, so... might as well play it like that. Look at this. We still have one last grenade. 3 points of damage will bring him down to 6, and that's the minimum damage that our heavy is doing. If we move up, we will have better aiming chances.
Okay, I'll go.
But let's take a gratis shot before we all in. 70% is also fine. Yeah, and that finished the job. If that wouldn't have hit, I would have just moved in. Good, I think there is no third wave of reinforcements. If I'm not mistaken, that has been it. Let's reload just in case there is. Nope, there is no more reinforcement material incoming. Yeah, and I think that's going to be our Blacksite mission. Pretty much looks like a flawless run, guys. Pretty much looks like a flawless run. With the exception of one trigger, one additional pack that I triggered, the rest was pretty damn good.
Mission accomplished,
Commander. 36 aliens, guys. I promised you some sick advent resistance. That is indeed a lot. 36.
Something tells me the aliens won't take this lying down.
Lots and lots and lots of kills. They can be pretty happy. And we even, I think we even ended with, we used both of our beacons and all of the grenades. So yeah, no, pretty much we have used our complete material, but it was just enough for the mission. So yeah, worked out pretty well. Thirty-six dead aliens, and look at that beautiful, so many promotions. First of all, Nightcom, who can now either go for Bladestorm, free sword attack on any enemy that is entering from melee range. It's okay-ish, but we haven't upgraded the swords. Or we go for Implacable. And I know, if Rusticated would now be in the chat, he would be like, nah, Implacable is not good. But please believe me, guys, Implacable is not bad. We can reposition once, and that would save us. That can save us from situations like you've just seen it. Rush up there, shotgun in the face, killing, and retreating. So, yeah, I loved the action cam, by the way, as well. So that looked a little bit like chaos, but pretty good. Dopadizor has discovered Shadow Step, which is interesting. This sniper is no longer going to trigger Overwatch or reaction shots. So, yeah, I guess that's pretty much okay. So, quick draw, firing your pistol first action, no longer ends a turn. If we would go for a pistolero build, that would be our selection. Well, I think we're going to just do a solid sharpshooter here. Although Shadow Step as an ability itself does promote him to become more of a gunslinger. And I wanted to get one gunslinger because you guys asked me to also get one gunslinger. And not triggering Overwatch fire is not too bad for a gunslinger. Yeah, why not? For the lols of it, let's go for it. So it's basically two shots at a time. So we are going to go for pistoleros. Okay, so she now has rapid fire. Oh my god. A sniper with rapid fire. Wow. Wow. That's super valuable. Like, this is big time triple value. Not bad. Okay, so she's definitely 150% going to be a sharpshooter. Like, that is sick. Rapid fire, such a good ability. Good. Anyways, we're going to go for lightning hands because that I'm not a big fan of it. Lightning hands is extra damage if she needs to do it. Question from the chat: what triggers these hidden abilities? It's the AWC, bro, Advanced Warfare Center. I can only recommend you to build it as soon as possible. In my guide that you can find at Reddit, just type in Legendary Iron Man here, Legendary Iron Man guide, and you will definitely, the first hit on Google will be mine. There you will find a build pass with an explanation and all of the tips that you need to survive your own legendary run. Good. So we had now two builds with suppression. I'm just going to go for demolition now to see if that one works out well for us as cover removal. Suppression is good, don't get me wrong, but we haven't had a demolition build so far. I'm not a big fan of blast padding, so although we skill Grenadier here, I would still not go blast padding because I think it's stupid. We're going for demolition. You guys asked me for a little bit of a variety in builds, and this is what I'm providing now. Two autoloaders, one scope, increased aim by 5. Yes, thank you, sir. It's exactly what we wanted to have. I will begin preparations for a complete analysis immediately. Couple of supplies, and let's take a short look at our soldiers. Wow, that was successful. I really like the upgrades. Dopadeso unfortunately now has the extended magazine. That's a little bit of a waste, but yeah. Not going to rant too much about it. Our other sharpshooter, who is going to be our main sharpshooter, she already has the scope. We could give her an autoloader, which is not too bad for now. And we can give her a superior expanded magazine later. We don't have the ability to change without losing the upgrades for now. Good. What else? We are having one more Grenadier weapon upgrades. She doesn't have any, so I feel giving her a little bit more ammunition might not be too bad. Let's take a look. Nightcom has his weapon upgraded. That's okay. Wangstra has his weapon upgraded. That's also okay. Roby has his weapon upgraded, of course. Rusticated has weapon upgrade. Teardrop, our reserve leader, could use the scope here. Yes, please. And I would like to get him a stock as the second one because he doesn't have Comet Protocol, and I'd like to give him the stock as the second option. Our remaining Ranger could use Laser Sight, yeah, for additional crit. The autoloader is not really useful for her, so we will hold on to it for now. Good. Another Ranger training. I like it. We need a third ranger and we need another sharpshooter afterwards. Although our sharpshooters are really good now, so can't complain about that. We have a little bit more supplies. From a building perspective, let's just think that through, guys. If we go for a pistoletto build, we want to have the pistol upgrade, so that was a no-brainer. Elsewise, our gunslinger sucks. We could use mine shields, but I don't really like them at all. We need to wait for a little bit more mimic beacons. These one I like very much, so we probably will build more of them. Even after the nerf, they are pretty good. In terms of facilities, resistant comps and proving grounds are just on their way. And once this one here is cleared, we are going for Psy operatives. So yeah. I had three of each class, that is correct, but we had unfortunately one very hardcore mission where we lost one of our snipers and one of our rangers. So our total death count currently is 3. So we could now go for Avenger power. Not necessarily the best idea. Our problem is we need to now get to a new facility. We always had the this facility here as our lifesaver, but now there is no more life saving. Like, we need to concentrate making contact and be efficient with that.
Considerable progress against the aliens.
Very good. 500 income. That's what I wanted to see. And look at that. Also a little bit new staff available. That's not too bad. High alert. 50% less time to complete concealed missions. Wow. That's bad. We need to counter this one here. That's a really, really bad event. And let's get the supplies for now. It's only 3 days for 500 supplies, so yeah, we definitely would want to get them. We're not flying back to HQ, although there could be some additional staff. We're fine for now. We have 6 engineers, 4 scientists. That's okay. We need to make contact with the other regions. That's number one priority. And look at that, Refufu just became a ranger. That's good. That's very good. Because we were lacking rangers, and he's indeed a good candidate for the ranger position. Guerrilla Tactic School. Oh yeah, I found out something. Number one, we want to have a third sniper. Number two, we want to further train our specialist. Because the way that the training works, and we have now lost already 3 days, it's not optimal, but we will still handle it. The way it works is we always need to train for the next rank. I just read this up because I was wondering, like, Wangstress on so many missions, why the fuck is he still the fire team leader instead of godlike field commander? And the reason is we always need to train. So defiance, soldiers within command range get 5 bonus defense. That's better than it looks. That's definitely better than it looks. Or focus fire, it will grant you a cumulative aim bonus and 1 armor piercing on attacks against a specific target. That's also not bad. I have read up on both of these abilities. Focus fire is 4% cumulative. So for each additional XCOM operative, it's basically a 4% bonus. The problem with the bonus, so to speak, is Wangstra is already having like 100 active abilities that he can regularly spam. Like he has the option to use Haywire Protocol. He has Comet Protocol, he has get some, he could get threat assessment, like many abilities that he could also use, and he always has the option to rapid fire. So seldom you are going to see him like having an extra ability ready. So that's the reason why I think I'm going for the passive ability here, because 5 bonus is effectively in reducing the chance of being hit by 5, no matter where we stand. And that's pretty good. It includes himself. It's always active. So yeah, he's training for this now. which also means he's currently not available. So if we run into a mission, we will need to take our reserve specialist. The UFO is still hunting us. Damn, it's flying into our direction. I don't like that. I don't like it at all. Let's fly to the black market real quick. We could sell Alarium cores. Now, we don't want to do that right now because Alarium cores are going to be valuable from now on. How's our intel looking like? We need 80 more to make contact with the last region. We do have one superior perception, and that's by far the best PCS, so you would always want to go for it if you have the option to buy it. That being said, that's 50 intel, and we would want to get alien alloys, usually, and also that here. Wow, that's 150. We can't afford this. It's a little bit too much, but we can go for a superior PCS. It will definitely pay dividends. I can promise you guys, it's by far the best. And investing such a low amount, oh no,